American writers of all time, and he's also known as basically the face of realism. For those who don't know, realism depicts the lives of regular people going through their everyday lives, and what the difference between realism and, let's say, romanticism is that realism does not have that exaggerated kings and queens and heroes and lords and princesses helping each other and lived happily ever after type of stuff. However, even in realism, James's style featured a certain characteristic that separated him from other fellow writers. It is what defined Henry James as an author, as a novelist. That certain characteristic is that since Henry James grew up in a wealthy family, his family traveled a lot. I mean, they lived in Switzerland, France, and especially the United Kingdom. The influence of Europe, and especially that of the UK, is widely portrayed in all of his writing, and the characteristic that I was talking about is that you will often see an American character interacting with an English character, or let's say, him interacting with the British society, the culture, and the people, or vice versa. You can have a British character doing the same thing with American society. The whole aspect of competition between the United States and Britain and the difference in thought, mentality, and values has always existed and still exists today. I mean, you see the competition in industry, especially the automotive. For example, you have a battle between luxury cars like Cadillac, Jaguar, you also see this in music, for example, the Beatles. Shake it up, baby, now. Shake it up, baby. Twist and shout. Twist and shout. Rolling Stones. Led Zeppelin. Long time, the long time. Lonely, 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 lonely. On the American side, we have Jimi Hendrix. Excuse me while I kiss this guy. Oh, hey. Aerosmith. Michael Jackson. Also, let's not forget about sports. Olympics are often dominated by United States and United Kingdom and China, but it is usually that the American and the English athletes compete against each other in sports such as swimming or canoeing or running. Each country dominates a given sport. For example, the United States are the dominant basketball team and as they dominate the basketball world. Meanwhile, England is the soccer powerhouse and simply one of the greatest national teams of all time. Whether you're Team Obama,
all of you know who I am,
or Team Queen Elizabeth, it is important to understand that this is not a hate-based competition. Instead, it's a blessing in disguise because it's a very healthy rivalry which only leads to more innovations, new inventions, people reach new goals, new heights, and without even knowing, they just create a better world, and that is what the ultimate goal should be for everyone. In the case of Henry James, I believe that his internal struggle was won by Britain because in the end, he did move to United Kingdom to live for good, and he actually became an English subject in 1914. Nevertheless, many people still consider him to be one of the greatest American novelists of all time, despite his close relationship and ties with England and Europe.